actually like a very aggressive style. There are some people who like an aggressive style. There are some people who like a more impartial, balanced, laid-back style. And it's a matter of everyone's personal choice. Maybe we should have throw it open to a snap poll. Okay, how many people in this audience would really like, who think an anchor should be aggressive? How many people? Okay, there are enough. And the people, okay. Maybe people also are being a little wary of saying that in front of me because they know that's not necessarily what I would do, but still. But okay, there are enough people. You know, 25% of the audience watches that. So they're people who like it. Okay, lady here, and then I'm going to go to the back. Yeah.
My question to you is that, like initially you said that your luxury is trying to cover a story and you could plug your loophole so that before broadcasting you have enough resources and facts. Before broadcasting, but now you have not only lack of time but also lack of resources. Is it because that most of the journalists are turning to the laptop?
Yeah, I mean, I think the point which you make is a valid point where there it's not that you, and I said it from the start, that unfortunately you don't have that luxury of time and resources that we once had to go and do stories at deep length. But that's not an excuse, frankly. Because even if you have a day to do a story, there's no excuse to take the shortcuts that some journalists tend to take. There are enough stories that you can still do. I mean, look at the last 3 months or 4 months. There are lots of fantastic investigative work that has been done on all these scams. All of these scams have come to the forefront, and I mean, why is the government taking action? They're not taking action because the government one day woke up and said, oh, we want to arrest Raja, or we want to, you know, go after everybody in the CWG or anything else.
But media exposed the Raja case in 2007, but this wasn't brought enough.
Which one?
Raja case.